Hey, flying boats, how practical. Square Enix continues to deliver the goods for PSP owners with Final Fantasy IV, The Complete Collection, which includes a beautiful version of Final Fantasy IV that we're watching now, as well as Final Fantasy IV, The After Years, which is like the after party. All the chocobos get crazy. There's also art galleries, a soundtrack. It's quite good. So, without giving away spoilers or ruining anything, let me just say the game is awesome. But it starts out really slow. I may have lost patience in the first hour or two had I not been trapped on an airplane with nothing else to do, but then I soldiered through and found the real beauty of this game, which lies in its storytelling that just takes a while to get started, and the battles, which get a lot better the further that you get into the game and start mastering the variety of magic spells. Unlike a lot of other JRPGs, this one is more about learning your magic and what does what to who than just outfitting your party with stronger and stronger weapons, although you kind of do that as well. It's a nice balance between the two and gets very interesting when you play for a while. So somewhere around the 3-hour mark, it goes from being bland and kind of slow to really cool. This is a look at the battle screen. My party is on the right. Someone has been turned into a pig, which is good because everyone's in the mood for a ham and chocobo sandwich to celebrate the eventual victory. Final Fantasy IV was originally a 1991 release on the Super Famicom. You could also get it for the Bandai Wonderswan. The presentation is, as you can see, lively, colorful, fun to look at for a long period of time, even though the enemy animations, well, they're not very animated. They just sort of float there and blink when they attack you. But the magic spells look great. The game begins with dramatic tension. You meet your main character, Cecil, who I renamed Disco X, and embark on a fabulous adventure where you meet new friends, have members join your party, leave your party. There's airships, you'll laugh, you'll cry, and don't forget to stick around for the after years. There's free drinks. There's been quite a few old-school JRPG remakes on the PSP, like the excellent Ys Chronicles, and Final Fantasy IV will not disappoint fans of the genre. The game plays very well on Sony's handheld platform. The controls work well, it sounds great, and the visuals fill up the screen and are easy to read. You can move around with the analog stick or D-pad, and you can set the battles to autopilot, which is handy for early in the game when you don't need to rely on magic or strategy. Later on, you'll do away with that, especially for some of the more difficult enemies, but for grinding through the easy ones, autopilot is a nice feature. I haven't played one of the older versions of this game, but I've really enjoyed it on the PSP. The presentation is just fabulous, and the storyline, once it gets started, is one that you'll want to see through to the end. If you start playing the game and you find it way too easy and way too slow, give it some time. Once you find out how evil your adversaries truly are, you'll want to vanquish them forever, for the final time, until the next Final Fantasy. I don't think they understand what that word means. Would it be as good if it was called Continuing Fantasy? Never-ending fantasy? Final-tastic fantasy? Whatever. JRPG fans, pick this one up. Final Fantasy IV, The Complete Collection.